Merhaba, this is Sharik, and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Eric. As you may have noticed, I'm sitting in the kitchen. I prepared some cutlery and kitchen utensils, and we will learn the names of these in Lebanese Arabic. Before we begin, let me first ask you to subscribe to my channel if you like my lessons. Also to follow me on my Instagram and on my Facebook. Simply write Globetrot with Arabic and you will find me. So let's begin. I have here my cutlery. So I will start with the knife. I will say heidi sikkine. I'm using heidi. Why? Because sikkine is a feminine word and heidi means this or this is in the feminine form. So heidi sikkine. This is a knife. Heidi shawke. Heidi shawke. This is a fork. Again, I'm using the feminine form because these two are feminine words, shawke and sikkine. Heidi sikkine. Heidi shawke. Heidi mala'a. Heidi mala'a. I can also say heidi mala'a kbire because it's a big spoon. Heidi mala'a kbire. Heidi and this, heidi mala'a zghire. So mala'a kbire, mala'a zghire. You will also hear people pronounce it mala'a instead of mala'a. It's the same. So heidi mala'a kbire, heidi mala'a zghire. هيدا صحن غميق. غميق in Arabic means deep. So when I say صحن غميق, it's this soup plate or bowl. So هيدا صحن غميق. And هيدا, we can just simply say هيدا صحن. If you want, you can say هيدا صحن فايش, like flat. هيدا صحن فايش. هيدا صحن غميق. We have, this is the one that you put your ice in, you freeze your ice. We say hayda jarur talij. Jarur in Arabic means drawer. Like for example, if you have the kitchen drawer or the drawers in your room. But when it comes to ice, we also call this a drawer. So hayda jarur talij. Talij means ice. It also means snow, by the way. Talij, ice or snow. But of course, in this context, we mean ice. So هيدا جرور تلج. We also have, you know this thing you take your soup out with? So هيدا كفكير. So you notice with جرور تلج, I said هيدا because جرور is masculine. هيدا, not هيدي. And this is the same. كفكير is a masculine word. So I have to say هيدا كفكير, not هيدي. When a word is masculine, you use هيدا. When a word is feminine, you use heidi. So, heida kafkir. Heidi kepshe. You know when you fry your, I don't know, French fries or something and you need to take them out? You use this. So, heidi kepshe. Kepshe. Again, it's a feminine word. Heidi assara. Assara. Literally juicer. It comes from the word asir. Asir means juice. Assara is a juicer. Heidi assara, because it's a feminine word. This is also a mal'a, right? But it's made of wood. So I'm gonna say heidi mal'a'at khashab. Khashab means wood. So when I say heidi mal'a'at khashab, it means it's a spoon made of wood. So heidi mal'a'at khashab. وهيدي فتيحة. فتيحة is an opener. It comes from the verb فتح, يفتح, to open. So هيدي فتيحة, it's an opener. It finishes with the ت مربوطة. Again, because it's a feminine word, it finishes with the ت مربوطة. But I'm not pronouncing it هيدي فتيحة. But the moment I mention what is it, an opener of what? For example, I can say هيدي فتيحة علب. In this case, I'm pronouncing the ت مربوطة. Why? Because it's followed by a noun, which is علب. And علب means boxes in Arabic. It's the plural form of علبة, which is a box. علب is boxes. So هيدي فتيحة علب. This is an opener of boxes. But actually, what we mean by boxes in this context is cans. So we also say علبة or علب in Arabic. So هيدي فتيحة, when I'm saying it alone, I can say that. I can also say هيدي فتيحة علب. Okay, we have here, this is something you peel the potatoes and the carrots with. So هيدي إشارة, إشارة, هيدي إشارة, إشارة. It comes from the verb يأشر. يأشر is to peel. إشارة is a peeler. هيدي إشارة. And this also is a فتيحة. فتيحة. It comes from the verb يفتح, as we said. But this is a bottle opener. So I'm going to say هيدي فتيحة أنينة. أنينة is one bottle in Arabic. أنينة is bottles. So this is a bottle opener. We will use the plural form of bottles. So I'm going to say هيدي فتيحة أنينة. But alone, again, I can just use هيدي فتيحة. So again, you can say هيدي فتيحة or هيدي فتيحة أنينة. Then you pronounce the same as Buddha. هيدي مصفية. So هيدي مصفية كبيرة وهيدي مصفية صغيرة. مبشرة. مبشرة is a grater. We also have the word مبشور, for example, grated. For example, جبنة, cheese, مبشورة, grated cheese. So that's why this word comes from the same family. It's مبشرة, grater. So مبشرة, it's a feminine word. So we say هيدي مبشرة. Now, هيدا بريء. هيدا بريء. It's a masculine word. That's why I use هيدا. هيدا بريء. Okay. Now, we have this. هيدي طنجرة. هيدي طنجرة. This is actually the طنجرة. And this is the cover. وهيدا الغطا. هيدي طنجرة وهيدا الغطا. Now, this is actually a perfect opportunity to teach you a very famous Lebanese expression that says طنجرة ولقيت غطاها. طنجرة ولقيت, and it found, and she found, غطاها. غطا is the cover. غطاها means her cover, which means its cover. طنجرة ولقيت غطاها. When do we use this expression? Say, for example, I meet someone, I met a guy, for example, and we are a bit similar, we are actually very similar, and we are a good match. We say, طنجرة ولقيت غطاها. A cooking pot which found its cover. طنجرة ولقيت غطاها. This can be also, for example, if two people are friends and they are very similar and they have maybe the same jokes or the same habits, we say, طنجرة ولقيت غطاها. طنجرة ولقيت غطاها. You see how I'm pronouncing it with the liaison? I'm not saying طنجرة ولقيت غطاها. لا. طنجرة ولقيت غطاها. Which means those two people are really, really compatible and they are very, very similar. طنجرة ولقيت غطاها. Now, this is a frying pan, so it's a مقلية. هيدي مقلية. مقلية. And when I say مقلي means fried. For example, بطاطا is a feminine word. If I want to say fried potatoes, I say بطاطا مقلية. بطاطا مقلية. And this is the fryer, that's why it's the مقلية. Literally, it means fryer, which means frying pan. هيدي مقلية. I made a mess here. Okay. This one, you know what? We just simply call it Tupperware. I simply say Tupperware. Tupperware with a pronunciation that is a bit weird. Okay, now this one is مدقتوم. This is very common to use in Lebanon, by the way. In London, they don't use it a lot. When I'm there, we use the other one, that like we press it. We don't really use that one in Lebanon a lot. We still use this one. So this is مدقتوم. مدق. That is like literally just to touch, also to, you know, to break something like that. So مدقتوم. مدقتوم. So مدقتوم. Now, sometimes Actually, this is another opportunity to teach you something else. You know when somebody is like very short or a bit like chubby, but maybe not necessarily short, but they look short because they are chubby. So we can say in that case, oh, I hope you say it as a joke, but not as a way to bully someone. We say, is this person is مثل مدق التوم. مدق التوم is like they look like this garlic breaker. By the way, توم means garlic, as you can remember from my previous Arabic lesson. Okay, my niece is crying. Okay, so that one is مدق التوم, and this is مرتبين. مرتبين is a jar. All of this is مرتبين. So هيدا مرتبين, because it's just one jar. هيدا مرتبين. هيدول, because it's in the plural form, because they are more than one. هيدول مرتبين. مرتبين. So هيدا if it's masculine, هيدي if it's feminine, هيدول if it's plural. هيدا مرتبين. هيدول مرتبين. Now this one has coffee, so we say هيدا مرتبين قهوة. هيدا مرتبين قهوة. Coffee. وهيدا مرتبين sugar is هيدا مرتبين سكر. وهيدا مرتبين it says tea. We don't usually put tea in it, but let's say هيدا مرتبين شاي if it had tea in it. But most probably in Lebanon you will find something else in it, either coffee or salt, for example, because I don't know, maybe we drink more coffee than tea. For sure we drink more coffee than tea. So هيدا مرتبين زعتر. Time. هيدا مرتبين زعتر. وهيدا مرتبين قهوة. وهيدا مرتبين سكر. وهيدا مرتبين شاي. And if it had salt, I was gonna say هيدا مرتبين ملح. ملح, which is salt. هيدا مرتبين ملح. Now هيدا مرتبين عسل. Honey. هيدا مرتبين عسل. وهيدا مرتبين شوكو ماكس, which is Nutella, but we call it Choco Max. وهيدا مرتبين Choco Max. وهيدا مرتبين عسل. Now, we have here the oil bottle, which we call مزيتي or مزيتي. مزيتي or مزيتي. It comes from the word زيت, which means oil. So مزيتي or مزيتي means the bottle that has oil inside. This is a box and it has tomato jam in it. So we say علبة, which is a box. هيدي علبة رب البندورة. Alone, it's a علبة. A box is علبة. It's not علبة. Now you know, the moment we put a noun after it, which makes it an إضافة, noun plus noun, then we have to pronounce the T مربوطة. And instead of saying علبة, I'm gonna say علبة رب البندورة. رب البندورة. رب is jam and بندورة is tomato. رب البندورة with the L, with the liaison. رب البندورة is the jam of the tomato. علبة رب البندورة, a box of tomato jam. We have here, it has salt inside. So مملحة, we call it a مملحة. And we have another one in Lebanon that is, usually you will find it in Arabic restaurants. It is like a small little plate that has salt and pepper. Even if it has salt and pepper, we still call it مملحة. مملحة. And this one, there's no, like, it comes, actually this one comes from the word ملح, which is salt. That's why we say مملحة, literally a salter or something. But we don't have the same. For example, this is بهار, okay, which is pepper, but we don't say مبهرة. Just like here, for example, ملح, we say مملحة, but for بهار, we don't usually say مبهرة. We just say, for example, for in this case, I can say أنينة بهار. Is it a bottle or a box? I'm not sure. علبة بهار. Anyways, now this one, even if it's a can, in Arabic, we just also call it علبة. But if we want to refer to canned food in general, for example, we say معلبات. معلب literally means boxed. معلبات means boxed in the plural. But when I say معلبات, we immediately understand that it's the products that come in cans like these. So معلبات. But when it's alone, I don't say معلبة. I just say علبة. This one has corn inside, so هيدي علبة درة. هيدي علبة درة. Now, this is also a bottle, so I will say Heide and Nine, and it has inside vinegar. So Heide and Ninit with a T marbuta. Now I'm pronouncing it Heide and Ninit Khal. So alone it's Anine, but together when I'm saying what's inside it, I say Heide and Ninit Khal. Khal is vinegar. Heide and Ninit Khal. We have here a big salad bowl, so it's Heida Jat. Jat. Heida, it's a masculine word. Heida Jat. And let's come here to our cups. So, Heide, feminine. Heide, kibbeye. Heide, kibbeye. Heida, finjin. And it has a small plate. You can say, Heida, sahan zghir. Heida, finjin. Heida, sahan. And this is another one. Heida, finjin. So, in Lebanon, when you go to your visitor's house, this is usually what we give coffee in, because our coffee is really strong, so you don't drink a lot. But usually this we use it for non-Lebanese coffee or tea. But this is very, very common. It's part of Lebanese culture even. So Hayda Finjin, if it has coffee, I say Hayda Finjin Ahwe, or Hayda Finjin Shai. What is this? You already know, I already told you. It's also Bri. Hayda Bri. The same as the other one that I told you. This one, Heida Bri Mai, for example, Heida Bri Chai, if it's tea, or Mai Sukhni when it's hot water. Heida Bri Mai Sukhni. This too, we call it Finjain. So, know the difference between Finjain and Kibbeye, mug and cup. Finjain, Finjain, Kibbeye. And finally, I have here Sainiye. This is what you put your food in, or it's a tray basically. So sainiye, heide sainiye, it's a feminine word, heide sainiye. And finally, I don't know if you can see this big gallon of water, if you can see it, it's like this 20 liter thingy. So that's also gallon, we say in Lebanon, gallon mai, a gallon of water. I think I showed you everything. Yes, I showed you everything. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, remember to subscribe to my channel, click on the bell so you can receive notifications from me every time I upload a lesson. Also follow me on Instagram at Globetrot with Arabic, and Facebook as well at Globetrot with Arabic. This really, really encourages me to upload more and more lessons on a daily basis. Thank you very much. Shukran, and see you soon. Ma salame. Bye. Yalla bye. Shufkun. Shufkun bukra. See you tomorrow.